Listen, here's what happened yesterday. So I'm listening to your program. It's the middle of the day. I had a day off. I thought, you know what, I'm going to take a nap. Like anything, I thought, I just started Googling your name, you know, because I enjoy your show. And I'm very intrigued with what you do. And I thought, well, I'll just get a little bit more information. And boom, out of nowhere, I read this article that says that you're a Freemason. Now, let me first of all say that I haven't met a Freemason that I haven't liked. But for years, I've had a concern, and my mother is married to a Freemason, and this guy is, again, you know, I enjoy his company, but I'm always digging for information and trying to gather things, getting them to slip so that, you know, I can try to educate myself around things. But ultimately, the other day, he said, are you ever going to join? Told him, I said, Jesse, here's the deal. I'm not going to join, and I'll tell you why. Masons are at the head of every global organization there is, and I've heard that you guys do wonderful things. I'm sure that you do. However, how can this world be in the condition that it's in if you guys are at the top of politics?
I think you've made two really great points. Let me try to respond to those. We'll put you on hold for a moment. Come back, let you have a response, then I can go to Tara, John, and others. You know, I have to probably say that I have major Masonic roots. I have never been part of a Masonic lodge. I have never taken Masonic oaths or rituals. A lot of my family, because Texas was pretty much Masonic through and through, was Masonic, high-level Masonic. And they were very, very good people. George Washington was a Mason. And all it is a university study of religions, of philosophy, and of building, and of mathematics, and of agrarian systems. And so what you see as Masons today is just those schools going on. And there have been hundreds of different variants and groups, and Rosicrucian orders within the Masons, and the Illuminati, founded in Germany, was a counter Illuminati to the real Illuminati, Sir Francis Bacon, all of that, hundreds of years before the Jesuit priest Adam Weishaupt. The modern Illuminati was a Catholic spinoff in an attempt to take over the Illuminati and the Rosicrucians. And yes, undoubtedly, my family on both sides on the Mayflower, hardcore Protestants, you could say Rosicrucians. This country was founded by real Rosicrucians, not the Rosicrucians you see out there today. And so undoubtedly, if you want to say it, I mean, I would say I come out of a classical Enlightenment family of what you would call real Illuminati, real Enlightenment. And I'll just say it here. When everybody asks me who I am, I'll tell you. There's no secret society. There's no secret messages. There's no secret handshakes. There's freedom. There's Jesus Christ. There's free market. There's family. There's the will to fight tyrants. That's what there is. The will to fight evil. The will to build a new civilization. The will and the dream to build that new Atlantis was special and was pure. And now the globalists have hijacked the new Atlantis, and they've used it to take over the world and sell the opposite of what this country was founded on, and it tears my heart out. So it's easy for lesser men to write an article claiming I'm in some secret society and a Mason. I'm in the Society of Humanity. There are no secrets.